This is me in Calabar. Not me. But the necktie the same. Same necktie everywhere. Graduated from one high school. So I bought this necktie around 3-4 dozen. Wear it every day. So that have no need to choose anything. So I'm a president of FIABCI-Thai. Doing property valuation. We are not developers, except my wife doing one hotel and one office building for rent. And a few land subdivision, because we want to buy land to build our school, and we sell it. Have to subdivide so that it will be valuable. So first, let me say something about the housing market here. You may see that in Bangkok, this is very big area, around 8,000 square kilometers. The Bangkok metropolitan region, 8,000 square kilometers. But Bangkok alone, 1,568 square kilometers. So around one-fifth of the total. However, Bangkok is the primate city. You can see that no other city bigger than Bangkok. So you can see all those projects surveyed since 1994. We collect the information like the brochure of all the developers since 1994. Keep in the computer and also in our warehouse. We hope that in the next 100 years, I will sell this brochure to the great grandson of the big developers today. Maybe at that time, we will become very rich because all those brochure may be something like antique at that time. And this is the situation. You can see that in 1997, there may be no launching real estate. But now, it is in the recovering period after COVID-19. But my brother said COVID-19 will come back. Anyone got COVID-19? Yeah, I got also once, Paris, last year. My friend have already 7 jabs, 7 injections. You got COVID. That isn't. And you can see that this is Bangkok right now. So many projects. But our projects here, the number of units, 100 units per project, 150 per project, not big projects. Unlike in Indonesia, in have so many townships. I missed Neko, Yasa, big township. But in Thailand, mostly are small. We also have townships, but not so successful. In the past, have township like Mueang Thong. And then we found that we should be in different location so that we'll be less risky. And then we also need to have in different high range. Some developer may build high income housing and so low income housing so that they provide group of customers. Case of Thailand. You can see in the last half of the year, around 199 high projects already. This year, we expect that there will be more units offered compared to last year. Another thing is that we have around 45 listed companies in Bangkok, Thailand. And you see listed companies and their subsidiaries may own around four-fifths of the total supply. So this means that this industry is most monopolized by something developers. And the first 10 developers occupy half of the market. Half of the market occupied by big developers. So if anyone teaching other people to try to build small projects, SME projects, that may be very much endanger because cannot be able to compete with small with big developers. So this is something that we have to keep in mind. And we expect that this year there will be further recovery. During COVID-19, for COVID-19, you can see that every year there may be around 100,000 units launched in Bangkok. However, during COVID-19, the year 2000, we have only 73,000 units per, and then 5,000 units per. But last year, 100,000 already. This year also another 100,000. But if we ask developers, they say that this year will be really bad. Maybe they want the government to help them. So they will say that it is really bad. However, if wherever they sell, they will say that it is really good. If they are selling something in the north of Bangkok, they will say that that area is really good. Or if they are selling something in south of Bangkok, they may say that that area is really good. So because they are selling in that, it's the nature. But they try to say that it is not good today. It's some government helps of something. Scrutiny in listening beneficiaries involved in real estate. But for us, the consultants, valuers, they are researcher, find out truth. And you can see in the model that the market is now recovering to some extent. Not be said that it is going to be down again. Maybe next 5 years, after next 5 years, there may be some COVID, maybe down again. Or because of the overbuilt, overconstruction today, there may be some oversupply in the future, but not right now. Right now, it is in the recovery period. Next year, we expect that there's still more new projects coming up. But year before, year afterward, 2026, they may be declining because of oversupply. Can happen in 2026, 2027. But right now, still okay. And this is the price changes. You can see that the price going up and down during the pandemic crisis. Now going up again, down. Except the low cost housing. Low cost housing, something like those social housing. Social housing may be priced less than 1 million baht per unit. 1 million baht per unit is around $30,000 per unit. Those things may be not in good because they have no good property management. Like Mr. Victor Lim said, that it's proper. And if there is no proper property management, there may be a lot of. If you buy low cost or social housing in the fringe of Bangkok, if you buy, say, maybe only $10,000 per unit, $10,000 per unit, not $10,000 per square meters. We have also some $10,000 per square meters, but those are $10,000 per square, per unit. If you buy those units, you may be crying, because even if it may be on the third floor, maybe flooding, not because of storm surge, because of the defect. Water supply. So we should buy something that not so cheap. If we buy something cheap, we cry several times. If we buy something expensive or reasonable, we will cry once when we pay, right? And then land prices in Bangkok, we collect information since 1980 something until today. See the trend of land prices in Bangkok. Nowadays, land price still change, still increase because of the mass transfer. Doesn't mean our economy is good. Our economy may be ranked at number 7th ASEAN countries. Number 1 may be Vietnam, Cambodia, Indonesia, formerly Myanmar, leading. Thailand maybe before Singapore, maybe before Brunei, they are number 8, number 6. However, land price still going up drastically, or at least constantly. Why land price is going up constantly? Because due to a lot of mass transit. Now we have around 150 stations, coming to be 180 mass transit stations. Nearby those mass transit stations, you can see that the land price going up because the potential. We also have busway, something like in Jakarta, but busway in Thailand not work well because it won't substantial change in price or increase in land. fortunately have only one busway goes, and that busway is going to be bankrupt because they have no earning every year. And you can see here that we have around 200,000 on the hand of developer for sales. This is an overhang unit. Malaysia, they said, this is an overhang unit. Most of them may be townhouse mean barrack types. This is all the survey came from our agency for real estate. Largest estate in the center, because we is in 94. And one of the sent to the Ministry of Finance to give birth for housing banks estate in the center. And another thing you consider that is the factor of high housing, unoccupied housing units. Bangkok, we have around, in Thailand as a whole, have around 1.2 million. Brunei, they have only 400 to 500,000 people, 400 to 500,000 people, but we have 1.2 million in Bangkok, Thailand, it's only in Thailand. Korea, they said, have some student friends here also. And also Japan, they said 8.5 million. This is something considered economic waste. But in China, they said there may be about 50 million. Many people like to buy and speculate. There may be so many post. There are also one big project that is Green City, and no one stay there. So maybe a lot of snake, a lot of mosquito or something that we should keep in mind when we do. You may know that in Thailand, no one else, no other real estate telling you that how many unoccupied, like vacant housing like this. And maybe many developers, they don't want to let people know. People may be frightened. Maybe they don't want to buy first-hand housing. They want to buy second-hand. But this is a fact that we should know. Because when we buy properties, buy a house, nearby there are so many unoccupied housing and so many second-hand housing units are waiting for sales. Maybe if we buy first-hand housing in that area, maybe not a wise investment is something you have to keep in mind. About foreign buyers, you can see that this is condominium in Bangkok alone. Condominium in Bangkok alone, you can see that before COVID-19, 2019, in 2019, maybe about 15% of the value of condominium bought by renters. So that before COVID-19, 70%, around third of condominium units bought by end users. Another 20% bought by speculators. And another 15%, 10 to 15% bought by foreign buyers. So this is the proportion. So actually, the real demand is only third, but we have additional those 70%, 10 to 50% of foreign buyers. That's why property market is growing. That's why we can see that there are so many gurus in Thailand or maybe trying to let people to buy property, buy condo, so that they can earn unearned increment of value. They can have a passive income. Maybe those gurus be hired by big developers so that they encourage people property, help their property. And the case of condominium, mostly they are in the CBD, the business district. Like Rachada Pisek, our foreign friend may not know where is, but that is the new Chinatown and so many Thailand and like shop houses or stay there and rent the condo, their friends or something, Chinatown, and have their own restaurant, their own business. If you go to Beijing, if we want to buy sell something, that yeah, maybe relax. Many people buy properties, particularly in the central area. And if in the case of housing as a whole, you can see that can differentiate. We can distinguish to you where are those areas that people want to buy this year. So foreign buyers at the proportion of Chinese buying is the case. But maybe very much in details, you can download all the papers in the when you scan front of this room. So all now almost all the papers are in the website already, so you can download freely, and then you can look at it yourself in the. And this is the case of condominium in Thailand as a whole. There may be around 55,000 units bought by foreign bought in bank in Thailand, but 7,700 units bought by foreigners, and whereas 4,400 units bought by Chinese. And housing as a whole, 1 year in Thailand, will be around 200,000 units bought by people. And are those units prepared by real estate developers. And we found that we estimate 13,000 would be bought by foreigners. And for Chinese largest portion buyers. Also, grandmother also came from mainland China. If my grandmother did not come, maybe by now I will be really rich, because mainland China people are really rich today. So in some we found that there will be around 13,200 units across country, first hand and second hand, together will be around 27,000 bought by foreigners. The value will be around almost $4 billion. Investment will help boost our economy or not? Don't know. We have to consider yourself. And foreign on policy in Thailand, really easy. Come and buy property here. Can be really easy. You can buy a piece of land in industrial estate. Free problem. Free hole. I went to conduct valuation in Bako in Myanmar. We can just lend for. But here you can buy free hole. Case of Thailand. And then you can buy land, one right, maybe 1,600 square meters to build your own. Mention, if you invest some 40 million baht, that's only 1.3 US dollar, really cheap. See, the our law is really relaxed. So come and buy property here. Yeah. Number three, you can buy condominium, 49% of the total. The land, the building may be 10,000 square meters. You can buy up to 1,900. But if in the Eastern Economic Corridor, you can even buy 100%. So in your condominiums, the juristic body, maybe you can have meeting in Myanmar language. If the whole building bought by Myanmar people, or you can have a condominium units. When you have the meeting of the juristic body, you can speak in Chinese, ni hao, something, or also speak in Russian, because all can be bought by foreigners. You can build your own neighborhood. This may be different from Singapore. Heard from my Singapore friend that if you want to buy condominium units in Singapore, there will be some lottery. Like if you are Indian, Singaporean, where Chinese, Singaporean, maybe have to have lottery. You cannot just put yourself together in the whole floor, in the same floor, in the same corners or something. So that there will be no segregation. But in Thailand, you can do that. So come and buy property here. can build your own community, Myanmar community, Cambodian community here. And number four, if your business is accepted and also promoted by the Board of Investment, you can buy a lot of land to do your business anywhere outside the industrial estate. You can buy 10 rights of land in resort area because you can say that I now communicate by wireless. You have no need to be stay together with my workplace. So you can buy big pieces. But the government said that if you change your mind, pull your investment out of the country, you have to sell this property back to Thai people. That is fair also. But by that time, maybe 10 years, 20 years, the property price may be going up a lot, so they may earn a lot. And the capital gain tax here is really low. So come and buy property here. This is the best place to buy our nation. And then you can see that you can also lease properties. Say 50 years. My wife leased a piece of land for 30 years to build an office building about 10,000 square meters. Really, we can lease up to years. And we can lease up to 99 years if it is in the Eastern Economic Corridor. This is really easy. You are foreigners and do that. You have no need to set up a nominee company. Just come and do that. Because this is our foreigners. And illegally, you can set up a Thai firm. You may ask me to help you hold 49%. I hold, and you yourself hold, my friend from Mr. K.M. Tan, you hold 59%, I hold 49%, and set up a company. Or maybe you hold 49%, I also hold 49%, and I also have a Thai lawyer firm to hold another 2%, but that lawyer firm is loyal to my Myanmar friend. And this company can buy property because it means that this is Thai companies. But Mr. Kin may have a contract agreement with me that I owe him 10 million baht, so I cannot escape. I have to, if I try to sell my share, I have to also have to pay the debt to Mr. Kin or something. So I will not, we have to be loyal to Mr. Kin. So you can do that, but this is illegal. Other country, you cannot do that. But here, possible to do. This is some loophole. But I do not try to let you do that. There are so many legal ways that you can do that by property. And maybe you can convert to be Thai. Like many people also convert to be Thai. I went to teach valuation in Uganda for 2 weeks. I see so many Chinese also trying to convert to be Uganda people. Get married to Uganda ladies. That may be very interesting. So in that case, that also happened. So these are all the issues that can be done. And in Thailand, there is no buying tax. You may know that in Singapore, if you buy properties, you have to pay tax 60%. Say if you buy a condominium, that means say 20 million baht or 1 million US dollar, 1 million US dollar, you have to pay tax 600,000, 60%. In Hong Kong, they charge you 30%. In Thailand, free. Buy here. You can also buy in Singapore. Really good place to buy. Very secure. But here, there is no tax. So this is something that we may have to consider. And also, no property tax. We don't have. We have also, but really low. If you buy a big mansion in Phuket, worth around 2 million US dollar, 2 million US dollar in Thailand, you may not be able to pay, you may not pay tax, pay property tax. Because the government assessed value is lower than 15 baht. So if it is below 50 baht, you are exempt for tax. But if you are in USA, like our Thai Bangkok governor bought a house 70 million baht in Los Angeles or somewhere, he has to pay 1% of the tax for based on the value, based on the market value. But in Thailand, it is based on the government assets value that will be really low. Say, in the central business district in central world here, the property price may be 3 million baht. Say, 1 million baht per square meters. 1 million baht per square meters. But the government asset value may be only 200,000 baht per square meters. So maybe 1/5 only. So if you buy properties here, it will be an advantage. And there will be low capital gain either. That is also the case. So low inheritance tax. I went to conduct valuation of ski resort in Hokkaido. In Hokkaido, ski resort. Some billionaire in Thailand also want to buy, or billionaire in other country also want to buy ski resort in Hokkaido. But if you buy there and you keep it, give the asset to your daughter or your son or something, your daughter and your son have to pay a lot of tax. Say, if the property worth more than $5 million, the tax rate is 55%. If the property is more than $5 million, say $6 million, that 1 million, that is $6 million, minus $5 million, that is $1 million, you have to pay tax up to 55%. 55%, more than half. See, the government robs us. The government robs us. This government, not Thai government. But in Thailand, no need. If the property tax, if your property is less than, less than $3 million, exempt for tax, no tax. And every year, if you give your son or daughter, say maybe $800,000 of property, gradually give to your son and daughter every year, no need to pay tax. Very smart here for foreigners to buy properties in Thailand. So come and buy now. So this is in comparison. I just make some comparison for you. This is a case of Russia in Phuket. But our Phuket speakers cannot come today. You can see that Russian come a lot to Bangkok, to Phuket. For the first 7 months, they came around 400,000 people. Last year, they came only 200,000 people in the first 7 months. But this year, double. This is good news for Thailand. Very good news for Thailand. God bless Thailand. But when they come, they have their own business, like hairdressing or nailing. Or maybe they have their own application for taxi drivers. So our local people have no job. But if they come 40,000 every year, sooner or later, Phuket will be another province of Russia or Ukraine. That will be good news. Because the population of Phuket will be more educated or higher level of education and can speak foreign language as well. So that may be a good thing for Phuket. And this is a really luxury car. I love to have one also. So this is a case that some foreigners who may be in gray business, they own big cars and also own big mansion, big houses. So this happened in the case of Thailand, Bangkok. This is in Indonesia. My friend from Indonesia said that if you want to buy properties in Indonesia, you also have some minimum price that you can buy. So you cannot buy as low as in Thailand. In Thailand, foreigners may buy property at around 5 to 6 million baht, whereas our local Thai people may buy at the average price of 4 million. Foreigners may buy at 5 or 6 million, okay? They buy a little bit higher. But in Indonesia, they said you have to buy 11 million. So you cannot buy the same price as our local fellow countrymen. Otherwise, the property price may be going up. Our fellow countrymen will be disadvantaged. This is in the case of Thailand. So in this case, we don't have much on this, fortunately. Next. In Singapore, as I told you, they have also 60% of tax for buying tax. But we don't have that. If we have that, we maybe not many people will come to buy our property. In Malaysia, you can see that you can buy at least 1 million ringgit or 2 million ringgit. 2 million ringgit. That 2 million ringgit is around 7.5 million baht or 2 million US, say, 200,000 US dollar or something. If below that, you cannot buy. Otherwise, we will be affected to our fellow countrymen. So this is another wise policy. This wise policy could also learn from Malaysia. Get up Malaysia. And then, I'm just going to see. Malaysia. Next to Malaysia. So this is the price of the case of Indonesia. You have also different price. Next, this is in Singapore for the property tax. Next, please. Australia. In Thailand, we have a big developer developing something in Australia. He's my good friend. I can buy property developed by him in Australia. However, whenever I want to sell, by law, I have to sell to Australians only. I have to sell to Australians only. I cannot sell to my Thai friend. Because this is considered second-hand house. So really good so that foreigners cannot buy second-hand houses. So that property price won't go up unreasonably. But if I break the law by selling to my friend, and the government of Australia buy that I am doing something guilty like this, I have to be fined for 3 million baht. 10 baht maybe. What, around 100,000 US dollar? Not much. But I have to be in jail for 3 years as well. 3 years in jail if we break this law. But this not happen in Thailand or in many countries. So goodbye property here in Thailand. No problem at all. And then in New Zealand said that they won't welcome any foreign buyers anymore. But the opposition now said that if they win, they will allow foreigners to buy properties again. But right now, they still cannot buy properties. New Zealand, maybe New Zealand, they have only 4 million people. So their population may be really low. 4 million people. They may be afraid of foreign people to come and stay there. They have only 4 million people, although they have allowed 80 million sheep. 80 million sheep won't help. They won't allow foreigners to buy. And also in Canada, also the same. They have some banning on foreign buyers because they see so many there. I went to quite a few villages by Canada, by British Columbia, or in Seattle, or in Francisco, that the whole village may be stayed by Chinese or some other foreigners. Yeah. But right now, the situation may change. Not really welcome, unfortunately. And this is another case that the world is now somehow banning those foreign buyers. They said, why more countries are now banning properties buyers from abroad or something? Because they think there will be some problem happen if they allow them to buy their properties. Because the money may not help prosper a lot in the country. Like in Singapore, it should be really good. Because they tax, the buying tax. And also every year, they have also pay property tax. And if they want to inherit for our children, they have to pay tax. And they also have property gain tax. But in many countries, our tax system is really weak. So if we allow, there may be a problem happen. These are deep But it may be also really good if some foreigners come to see that they want to buy property, they will help them buy. Because by law, they can do that. But policy level, they have to be some fine-tune in the policy so that it will benefit our own country, not just only their properties. Otherwise, in the future, Phuket may be the town of Russian. Pattaya may be the town of Arabic countries or Indian. The past, 30 years ago, Pattaya dominated investors. Then after Arabic gone, maybe Japanese, maybe German, Englishmen, Russian, now Chinese, and future maybe Indian. Asian may change. The Eastern economy or maybe Indian. Oh, and definitely, Chiang Mai, our another beautiful north, lot of staying there, buying property. Some of them maybe can transform themselves legally or illegally to Thai, get married with Thai girls or something. But at least we will have more quality, population to be in Thailand. So come and buy now. This is something that happened. So this is our presentation. These people, they are our board members of the FIABC, the National Real Estate Federation. So I try to welcome everyone to be our members. FIABC, you can see that largest developers, those largest developers, Indonesia, in Taiwan, many other countries, our members, and also really big brokers, like Silver Line, our Farouk, and also our members. This is a nation, both in real estate. Then end of so highly our members, and in the case of Thailand, so I am willing to have rotation and see have people to join over. My plan is that we try to have our association. We have around 30 real estate associations. We would like to have them for president by rotation because of the obstacle that we have to pay membership. Not many. But right now, right now, we have our Thai Real Estate Broker Association as our principal member. Have the Thai Appraisal and Estate Association as our principal members. We also have the latest one that is the Asian Urban, our Asian Urban Energy Association as our principal member. Future we hope. Real Estate Sales and Market Association of FC. This will be a case change of ideas. You see only FC Thai organize this is okay. But if you go to FC World Congress, go to FC business, it meet more and more people. Future. So let me just inform you that December, I remember the date. December, early December, there will be FIABCI Business Summit. What is the date, man? 4-7 in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia. Never been there in my whole life. This will be my first time. So you can find us. It's really big developers in Arabia. So you can travel to Oman, countries that region, and learn, exchange a lot of other. This is something. And next year, in May, we will have our World Congress in Singapore. This year will be, next year will be easier for us. In region that we have a World Congress in Singapore. For 2010, the World Congress was in Miami. Next year will be our FIABCI family. Heard that the kin from also FIABCI Myanmar. And the man, they also trying hard materialize. Hope to have. They also have FIABCI Vietnam already. Vietnam Association of Association. Vietnam Realtor Association. Very good. For the rest of our ASEAN countries, already FIABCI chapters. So I think now it is time for lunch. Any questions so far, sir? Questions so far? Any comments or something? Dr. Om may like to ask one question. When will we go for lunch? When will we go for lunch? And any questions so far? Minkalaba, any questions so far? This means that we should stop.